गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ क्लास ट्वेल्थ मैथ्स लेक्चर टेंथ ऑफ चैप्टर सेवेंथ इंटीग्रल्स एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 7.4. सो क्वेश्चन थर्ड इज इंटीग्रल ऑफ 1 अपॉन रूट 2 माइनस एक्स होल स्क्वायर प्लस 1 इंटू dx. नाउ सी इन दिस वी कैन नॉट अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला ऑफ 1 अपॉन रूट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर डायरेक्टली बिकॉज हेयर द कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स इज माइनस 1. Therefore, let 2 minus x as equal to t. So, the derivative of 2 is 0 and of minus x is minus 1 into dx equal to dt. Now, this integral will become 1 upon root t square plus 1 and in place of dx minus dt. Now, integral of this is minus as it is log mod of t plus root a square plus x square plus c. Now in place of t write down 2 minus x, right? Now question number 4th is integral of 1 upon root 9 minus 25 x square. Here the coefficient of x is minus 25. So take 25 common from both of these terms. So you will get root 25 into 9 by 25 minus x square. Now this root 25 is 5. 5 is constant, so take it out because it is in the denominator. So you will get 1 by 5. Integral of 1 upon root in place of this 9 by 25. This is 3 by 5 whole square minus x whole square. Now apply the formula of the integral 1 upon root a square minus x square, which is sine inverse x by a. So x, a is this complete 3 by 5. So you will get sine inverse 5x by 3 plus c. Clear? Now in question number 5th, I have already told you in the previous lecture that in place of this 2 into x raised to the power 4, we want now t square. So root 2x square will be t. Therefore, let this root 2x square as equal to t, then after differentiating both the sides, you will get 2 root 2x into dx equal to dt. Now, this integral will become in place of this denominator 1 plus t square, and in place of x into dx, you will get dt upon 2 root 2 and this 3 as it is, right? Now, 3 upon 2 root 2 into integral of this is 10 inverse t plus c, and in place of t again put this value root 2x square, right? Now question number 8th is integral of x square upon root x raised to the power 6 plus a raised to the power 6 into dx. Now see, again a raised to the power 6 can be written as a cube square, and this x raised to the power 6 can be written as x cube square. Therefore, we will let this x cube as equal to t. Therefore, now after differentiating both the sides, you will get 3x square into dx equal to dt. Also, we can see x square exists in the integrand. Therefore, this will become in place of x square dx, dt upon 3 upon root in place of x raised to the power 6, t square, plus writing this a raised to the power 6 as a cube square. Now this is 1 upon root t square plus a cube square. That is, you have to apply the formula of 1 upon root x square plus a square, which is log x, here x is t, plus root x square plus a square, here x square is t square and a square is a raised to the power 6, right? Plus c. Again in place of t, put this value of x cube. So you'll get this as the answer. Clear? Now question number 12th is integral of 1 upon root 7 minus 6x minus x square into dx. So this is the quadratic equation inside the root in the denominator. So first of all, we will change this integral into the standard forms. Now if we compare this with the standard quadratic equation, then a will be minus 1, b is minus 6 and c is 7. So this can be written as, according to the formula I have told you, or you can apply the completing the square which you have learnt in the earlier classes. So this will be minus 1 x minus 6 upon minus 2 whole square plus 7 upon minus 1 minus 36 upon 4. How you will get this? A into x plus b which is minus 6 upon 2a. So 2 into minus 1 will be minus 2 whole square plus c upon a minus b square upon 4a square. So you will get this. Now when you will solve this, minus this will be x plus 3 whole square plus minus 16, right? Now see, this is equal to x plus 3 whole square, and because here this is minus, so you will get minus, and this minus 16 is minus 4 square, but minus is already here, so it will be plus 4 square. Clear? So you will get this integral as integral of 1 upon root 4 square minus x plus 3 whole square. Now the formula of the integral 1 upon root a square minus x square is sine inverse x upon a, and here x is complete, x plus 3, right, plus c. So this will be sine inverse x plus 3 by 4 plus c. Now question number 15th is 1 upon root x minus a into x minus b. So first of all, write this quadratic equation in the standard form by applying the formula. So this is x minus a into x minus b, which is equal to x square minus a plus bx plus ab. And when you will apply the formula, or you can also do it by completing the square method, you will get x minus a plus b by 2 whole square minus a minus b by 2 whole square. Now in place of this given integral, write down integral of 1 upon root x minus a plus b by 2 whole square minus a minus b upon 2 whole square. Now this is the integral which is similar as 1 upon root x square minus a square, where a is this complete a minus b by 2, and x is this complete x minus a plus b by 2, right? So you will get the answer as log mod of x, x here is complete this x minus a plus b by 2, plus root of x square minus a square, and this either you write this or this is equal to this only, so I have written this, right, plus c. Now see, there are some more integrals. So integral of the type px plus q upon ax square plus bx plus c into dx, that is in the denominator you are given with the quadratic equation and in the numerator with the linear equation of x. So what you have to do in these type of questions, write down this px plus q as equal to a into derivative of the denominator plus b. Now you have to solve this derivative and then compare the coefficients to get the value of a and b. Then in place of this px plus q, we will write this only, right? And in place of a and b also, you write down the values which you will get, right? So let us understand this with an example. So the integral is given as x plus 2 upon 2x square plus 6x plus 5. Now write down this x plus 2 as equal to a into derivative of the denominator plus b. Now a as it is, derivative of this will be 4x plus 6 plus b. So compare the coefficients of x first. So the coefficient of x here is 1 and the coefficient of x here is 4a, right? Now compare the constant term. Here the constant term is 2. And here the constant term is 6a plus b. So you will get the values of a and b as a will be 1 by 4 and b will be 1 by 2. Now when we got these values a and b, in place of this x plus 2, write down this only. So a is 1 by 4 into 4x plus 6 plus 1 by 2 upon same denominator as it is into dx. Now see, this integral can be written as 1 by 4 into integral of 4x plus 6 upon 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus 1 by 2 into integral of 1 upon 2x square plus 6x plus 5. Now you can easily solve both of these integrals. See, for the first integral, if you will let the denominator as equal to t, then the numerator is the derivative of the denominator only, right? So you will get 4x plus 6 into dx equal to dt. Therefore, this integral will become 1 by 4 integral of 1 by t into dt plus 1 by 2 into integral of this. Also, you know how to solve the integral of this. This quadratic equation can be written as 2 into x plus 3 whole square plus 1 by 2 whole square. Therefore, this integral will become 1 by 2 is already here. Also, you will take this 2 outside the integral. So, 1 by 4 into integral of 1 upon x plus 3 by 2 whole square plus 1 by 2 whole square into dx. Now, the integral of 1 by t will be log mod t plus 1 by 4 integral of this will be 10 inverse x by a into 1 by a. So this x is complete, x plus 3 by 2, a is 1 by 2, also 1 by a plus c. Now in place of t, again put the value which you assumed. So you will get 1 by 4 log mod of 2x square plus 6x plus 5 plus 1 by 2, 10 inverse, 2x plus 3 plus c. Clear? Now, integrals of the type px plus q upon root ax square plus bx plus c. Now, in the denominator, quadratic equation is given inside the root, and in the numerator, we have linear equation in x, right? So, in this also, you have to follow the same procedure. Write down this px plus q as a into derivative of ax square plus bx plus c plus b. Now, understand this with an example. If this is given to you, so you will write x plus 3 as a into derivative of the given quadratic equation plus b. Now, x plus 3 is equal to a into derivative of this will be minus 4 minus 2x plus b. Compare the coefficients. Coefficient of x is 1 and here the coefficient of x is minus 2a. So you will get a as minus 1 by 2. Here the constant is 3 and on this side the constant is minus 4a plus b. So you will get b as 1, right? Now, in place of x plus 3, write down minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 minus 2x plus b is 1 upon root 5 minus 4x minus x square into dx. Now see, separate the integral. So you will get minus 1 by 2 integral of minus 4 minus 2x upon this plus integral of 1 upon root 5 minus 4x minus x square into dx. Now for the first integral, if you will let 5 minus 4x minus x square as equal to t, then after differentiating both the sides, you will get minus 4 minus 2x into dx equal to dt. Therefore, this integral become minus 1 by 2 integral of, in place of this, root t, and in place of numerator into dx, you will get dt. Plus, now for this, 5 minus 4x minus x square, this can be written as 3 square minus x plus 2 whole square. So, in place of this, write down 3 square minus x plus 2 whole square. Now, this integral will become minus 1 by 2 integral of t raised to the power minus 1 by 2 into dt plus, solve this integral, this is integral of 1 upon root a square minus x square, which is sine inverse x upon a and here x is this complete x plus 2 and a is 3 plus c. If you don't understand this, that in place of x, why we have taken this complete, then let x plus 2 as equal to t first and then solve it. You'll get the same answer, right? Now in place of this, minus 1 by 2 integral of this is t raised to the power 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2 plus this term, same. Now this will be 1 by 2 will get cancelled. So you'll get minus root t, and t we assumed as 5 minus 4x minus x square plus sin inverse x plus 2 by 3 plus c, right? Now see the question number 20th of exercise 7.4, which is integral of x plus 2 upon root 4x minus x square into dx. So first of all, write down this x plus 2 as equal to a into derivative of 4x minus x square plus b. Now derivative of this will be 4 minus 2x. So compare the coefficients. The coefficient of x here is 1 and of x here it is minus 2a, and constant here is 2 and here the constant is 4a plus b. So you will get the value of a as minus 1 by 2 and the value of b as 4, right? Now in place of x plus 2 we will write minus 1 by 2 into 4 minus 2x plus b, which is 4, upon root 4x minus x square into dx. Now separate the integrals, you will get minus 1 by 2 integral of 4 minus 2x upon this plus 4 outside the integral into integral of 1 upon root 4x minus x square into dx. Now if you will let the term inside the denominator as t, so you know the numerator is the derivative of 4x minus x square only, so let this as t, then you will get 4 minus 2x into dx is dt plus 4 integral of 1 upon 4x minus x square can be written as integral of 1 upon root 2 square minus x minus 2 whole square. Now apply the formula. This is integral of t raised to the power minus 1 by 2, which is t raised to the power 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 as it is, plus 4 integral of 1 upon root a square minus x square is sine inverse x upon a. Here x is this complete x minus 2, a is 2 plus c. So in place of t, put the value. So we have assumed t as 4x minus x square. So 1 by 2 will get cancelled. You will get minus root 4x minus x square plus 4 sine inverse x minus 2 by 2 plus c. Clear? So your homework is you have to complete exercise 7.4. Okay, thank you.